Good afternoon. First of all, I want to present myself. My name is Maranda, and I am a PhD student from University of Oradea, Doctoral School of Sociology. And today I want to present my research related to how to conduct a systematic literature review by using computer text analysis, and especially using interesting visualization in order to get a better picture of the data that we have. Considering that the topic of my interest relates to deviance and cyber deviance in 21st century, I will illustrate this analysis by using some data, especially some literature review and some articles, main articles from the field, in the topic of deviance and cyber deviance. Before presenting the top, the analysis conducted, I will first introduce my research. First of all, computer test analysis, assisted analysis techniques provide a main asset in conducting research. Maybe you may ask why, but a main reason may be because it adds verisimilitude and both validity to the data. It allows methods triangulation, and it allows a more complex exploration of the data used. In this sense, I will basically refer to different types of word frequency theory queries and also some correspondence analysis. This topic is of great use. The topic that I present today, so this research is of great use, especially for PhD students and scholars that attempt to understand the main research topics, main themes, and basically to get a clearer picture of what happens and what those data mean. It's a good first start, sort of saying. And it enables the researcher to get more data, some data that is rather consistent and you don't find it at the first view. So to begin with a main analysis of the topic of today, which is deviance. According to the classical literature in the field of deviance, deviance may be defined as motivated tendency of an actor to act in opposition to one or more institutionalized social rules. It is a tendency of breaking the balance of the social system. And also it may be seen as a deviation from conforming to the moral rules which form mainstream culture. These were features of deviance were shown by Parsons' research, which is a classic in the study of deviance. Also, some more interesting theoretizations of deviance and a novel approach. It is the interactionist one, which saw deviance as a behavior against society's or community's norms, and basically, deviance is what determines social disapproval. In this context, the interactionist scholars understand deviance in relation to the social disapproval, a fact that is not approved by society. Ben Yehuda also employs the topic of deviance, and it sees deviance both its nature as a behavior that breaks social rules and the way it is judged by society. Okay, starting from this analysis of deviance, I made some categories, which is like a kind of sketching. What does it mean to be deviant? There are two main orientations, basically the positivist one. The positivist scholars perceive deviance as real and residing in the individual. A main theory, a positivist theory, is the social biopsychologic type of deviance. Deviance, it is an inborn capacity. And in this sense, we may find that the theories of scholars such as Hirschi, also the socially learning theory of Akers about deviance, and even the social genomical theories that say that deviance in inscript in our DNA, such as that of Mills and Troff from 2020, they actually made a literature review of the latest discoveries in the field of social genomic about the way deviance is inscribed in our DNA. Then the second orientation perceives deviance as a label, as a social reality, which actually means that deviance, as perceived by social constructivists, is not necessarily something that it is a fact, but rather the way it is perceived that fact. In this sense, relativism sees deviance as a subjective experience and also as an expression or a choice of a person. In this sense, we may also reside to Foucault's theory about power and deviance, and to Becker. We see the distinction between interactionist theorists, which consider that norms label deviance, and structural theorists, such as Foucault, like I already said, says that power labels deviance. So the deviant ones are those that lose power in relation to the others. When an act is considered or defined as deviant, the people, the group, or the people that are seen labeled as deviant lose the power in relation to the others. Also, a main concept of this review relates to cyberdeviance. What does it mean, cyberdeviance? The concept is even vaguer than the concept of deviance by itself. You may ask why. First, the way we perceive cyberdeviance and define cyberdeviance is related to the way we see deviance. We see deviance, we define deviance, and in accordance to this, we consider what is cyberdeviant. For example, whether we consider the cyberdeviance the intended misuse of computer-mediated communication, and comprising a range of distinct phenomena, from web surfing, productivity theft, cyberbullying, virtual harassment, disclosure of proprietary or sensitive information. Why do I say that it matters how you define deviance in order to understand the concept of cyberdeviance? This is mostly related to the way of understanding the concept of piracy, of virtual piracy. We may see that online piracy is a phenomenon, but if we consider that it is widespread, it may not be seen in opposition to the mainstream, but basically mainstream. And still, there are theories that consider it as deviant. In this sense, we understand that it is rather a label of deviance than an act existing by itself. So, in this sense, we may say that a deviant act of a particular group is what opposes established and emerging norms. But considering the online community, we have to ask the question, who governs the internet? And what are the norms of the internet? In these years, now, in the current period, we have the GDPR norms, and also the European Commission attempts to create a kind of code of conduct with relation to cyberspace. But still, even before existing this, there were some rules of considering this type of behavior as deviant and other type of behavior, not deviant. This type I was relating to the online piracy. And considering this, scholars understood it that the way we label deviance in the virtual world, actually it is a kind of continuing the label of deviance in the offline world, even if we consider that cyberspace is different from the main space. Okay, going forward, now I will present the methodology of this study. This study starts from being a systematic quantitative literature review, as understood by Pickering and Byrne in 2014. According to this author, systematic quantitative literature reviews allow PhD students to better understand and conceptualize the main topic of their research. And considering that it's a systematic review, I began with analyzing top 10% of the articles about deviance and cyber deviance indexed in the Web of Science database in the field of sociology between 2000 and 2020, ranked by the number of citations. And the main question of this research was, which are the main topics of interest of articles in the field of deviance and cyber deviance? At this level of my research, I tried not to take into consideration quite my topic of interest, mainly deviance and adolescence. Still, I developed the methodology in order to be of use also to my PhD research. So I understood, I made some queries, and I tried to also include some articles from the topic of interest of adolescence and deviance, considering that these topics were not ranked among the top cited articles. So, as I show in this slide, I identified 3,948 articles from the field of sociology related to the topic of deviance, out of which I selected top 10% of the articles by employing the criteria of usage count, a number of citations, filters, which are actually available in the Web of Science database. And here I noted the main queries of my research, made basically the list of keywords for deviance and cyber deviance. You may see here that I use some complex queries in order to take into consideration different types of defining deviance. In this step, I made two main lists, one of the top cited articles list, which comprised 34 articles, out of which 14 are the articles from the adolescence and deviance query, and those 20 are from the most cited articles in the field, like the top articles in the field of sociology that have this search, that got results to this search. So I made two main databases, one of 34 articles and one of 161 articles, which comprises other relevant articles in the fields of sociology, criminology, psychology, and social sciences that were actually selected from those 900 articles, but based on a manual inspection. So I saw the topic, the keywords, and also I read the abstract of those. And based on this data, I tried to check whether it is relevant for my research or not. Okay, so in this step, I had two databases. First of all, I analyzed the 34 articles top cited database. Here you may see the articles which are actually in this database and the composition of them. based on this list, I employed some queries. First of all, I used the topic modeling and a topic modeling, which is available actually on an online version made by the algorithm GSLDA, is made by David Minow, and allows the classification of these articles in the different classes. The researcher may even mention how many classes considers as of use. And after this topic modeling analysis, in order to see whether it has consistency, I read the abstract and also the whole articles, and I tried to check whether it allows a good classification in those classes. Also, a second analysis consisted of employing some other text analysis techniques with the use of QHCoder, another open source instrument that allowed the data analysis. So now I will present you the results of my research. First of all, here you may see the main topics and also the main classes, and the coverage of the articles in each of these classes. First, I considered as relevant all the coverages which are more than 8%, like in this category. What is under 8%, I did not include. The words are basically the words from the abstracts from the articles. I chose to analyze only the abstracts in order to respect this data scarcity and also to be able to check the results and their consistency. So based on the abstract analysis, which may also consist of a frame theory analysis, I distinguished these classes, and further on I tried to classify and describe them. So there are some classes noticed, basically there are like 11 of them. So first of all, I understood that there are a bunch of articles which analyze the life conditions of internal migrants and their disadvantaged socioeconomic status, the medical risks they are vulnerable to. And here you may see, as I noted, the main topics that were related, the words actually that were classified in this category from the abstracts: health, life, mental, migrants, rural, urban, relationships, medical, key risk. I have to mention that the words are taken word by word, and based on these words which were in the abstracts, basically the classes were constructed. The second class consists of deviance in families context, and it also has a main significance in this analysis. The main words from this class are deviant, substance, family, adolescence, relationship, peers, motivation, levels, parental, school. And the third class relates to deviance as understood as stigma, and from the point of view of stigma being understood as related to shame. And in this category, there were included words such as stigma disorder, sexual relations, girls, young, shame, deviation. Main article from this class depicts the process through which teenager girls adapt to the sexualization of childhood, which is perceived as a process outside the moral norms. The author implies the term schizoid subjectivities. You may find this article here on the list with the schizoid subjectivities. Basically, the schizei subjectivities re-theorizing teens girls sexual cultures in the an era of sexualization. Okay, going back to the article where I got the other category from this first four of them is related to deviance and victimization. And in this category, we find words such as well-being, risk, trauma, polyvictimization, profiles, victims, stress, stressors, exposure. In this category, I considered important the information from the cited article of Fordelhai et al. 2010, which is actually the link between exposure to multiple trauma and the risk in engaging in deviant behaviors. Going forward, there are some more classes, as I said, there are like 11. We have another class which relates to the relationship between labeling deviant groups and discrimination. And in this sense, the relevant words and the main words are behaviors, health, gender discrimination, transgender, physical role, distress, theoretical engagement. You may see the topic of labeling deviant is quite prominent in this category, especially if we think about the concept of transgender and about the transgender group as perceived as deviant. Okay, the next class relates to interaction between friends and deviant behavior. I have to mention that this peer deviance and especially the engagement of deviants as related to affiliation to peer groups seems to be a main topic of interest in the literature of deviance, both in the top cited and in other words that were considered as relevant for my study. So this class relates to the relationship between socialization and engagement in deviant acts. The main words are effects, mechanisms, network selection, inequality, educational, expertise, students' advantage, offending. Another class relates to a specific group of deviants, which is consisted of the children with incarcerated parents. The group is strictly delimited and it consists of articles of Wilterman. The main words are incarceration, effects, paternal aggression, consequences, mass imprisonment, empirical physical child. The articles basically describe the connection between father's incarcerations and especially son's aggression, even if the father was not aggressed, and also the effects of father's incarcerations on mother's well-being. So the parental incarceration seems to be a part of social stratification system to which deviance and crime is transferred from fathers to sons, a kind of vicious circle, sort of. Okay, another class related to the study of deviance perceives the interaction between online environment and social cohesion. This class actually refers most to political and political discourse and also to fake news issue. So it is the online deviance as perceived from the topic of incivility in political speech. And it basically includes articles related to online deviance. And even if it's about online incivility and YouTube content, and it conceptualizes the relationship between content, online content, and the label of deviance. Okay, so we have some more classes. Yes, another class which is quite interesting and these concepts may also be of great use for my research relates to social inequality and health related quality of life. The main words in this class are quality deviants, HRQOL, health related quality of life, survivors, age, friendship, association, differential, health related. The topic includes two main concepts related to the positivist approach on deviance, as you may see, namely health related quality of life and the differential association. Maybe you know this word from the theory of Sutherland. So, according to these scholars, health, mental health, and social functioning reflect social inequalities. And social inequalities are a risk factor on engaging in deviant acts. This is basically the connection between them. Another class relates to deviance, gentrification, and violence. And it basically makes a connection between the communities that are mostly vulnerable to deviance, engaging in deviance, where the deviance is most prevalent. And in this sense, you may find the words criminal neighborhood and also the gentrification and black national behavior and police. A main article from this topic relates to the unjustified violence of police in black neighborhood, black neighborhood. And according to this article, which I will actually cite to you, wait a second, police violence and citizen crime reporting in the black community. According to this article, unjustified violence of police leads to a lower reporting of citizens of the criminal behavior. So in this category are included articles of seeing the deviance as a particular deviance, but basically deviance which is mostly delinquency. Okay, the last class is kind of similar to this, but still it has even more connections with criminology. Is a class which I named Deviance and Criminology and includes an article of Williams and Thomas et al. 2020, where serial murders perceive murder as a type of leisure. Also, border studies, cohesion, framework, and ethnic are included in this category, which seems to conceptualize the fact that the framework, the ethnic violence, and the framework may be risk factors of engaging in deviance. According to my opinion, these two articles may be grouped in a single class, but in this sense, we lose the value of seeing murder as a leisure and the particularities of this concept. Okay, so going forward, analyzing the main classes that I showed may be realized also by employing Gephi and creating a network of these articles. And in this sense, I made a network of the articles ranked by modularity. I won't go deep on this network, but you may see that the articles seem to be connected. We have the blue category, which encompasses more articles, as you may see, the 23, 27, 28, 26, and also the 30 from the list. And also we have the purple, the red, and the green networks. There are not so many networks, and we see that there are connections between the networks. Okay, another type of analysis that I made in order to create a validity of the data presented and to see whether the topic modeling has a consistency, so the classes shown are relevant, relates to employing the QHCoder software and making some analysis, basically the co-occurrence network analysis, which relates to examining the relationship between words by showing connections between words that appear in similar contexts. And the technique implies Jacquard coefficient and distinguishes 11 subnetworks. So I chose to distinguish 11 subnetworks in order to be the same top number of topics and in the case of that topic modeling. In this figure, you may see the graph. In the figure, you may notice the main classes which have the largest coverage. What does it mean basically to have this coverage? It basically the words found together are words which were found in a similar in similar articles. So they were found together in the article, in the abstract. And in this way, it was realized a network, a subnetwork of those articles. You may notice that we have an article related to, a group of articles related to adolescence. And in this category, we have deviant association, health substance, school, also delinquency, parental education, contagion. Then we also have a class, which is a main one, related to well-being, discrimination and health, and polyvictimization in this category. So you may notice that this graph actually tries to incorporate those classes of topic modeling and creating larger structures. Then also a class related to rural to urban migrant medical health related quality of life. They are the class related to online incivility. You may see it here, incivility, Washington discussion, murder panic, political news, fake media. I have to mention that in this category, you may see there are mostly nouns. A smaller class, but I didn't underscore it. I did a market, is related to the neighborhood violence, the black neighborhood police gentrification and selection. A class related to disorder, survey and poor. Then all the class related to children's incarceration, which where you see there are not so many words, but still we have incarceration, mass consequence and family. And some other two scales in this part and other two in this, which are not so clearly distinguished. They have less factors. I have to mention that the size of these bubbles is related to the towards frequency. So we may notice that health, well-being, adolescent, substance, behavior, adolescent, quality, family were the top words out of this abstract. And according to this is a similarity coefficient. So those that have a clearer line between them are mostly related, are more associated than those that have a lighter line between them or an interrupted one, like in this case. Okay, going forward, another analysis that may be employed, it relates to multidimensional scaling of words. And this kind of analysis technique reveals combination of group of words with similar appearance patterns. It uses Jacquard coefficient and the Kruskal method of multidimensional scaling. According to this method, we obtained this figure. Again, words frequency and words association. It uses the Jacquard analysis and random walks techniques. This also allows from a selection of classes and the kind of classification technique. And basically, what is of great interest, even in this research, but also in the research that you employ for you and the using these techniques, is seeing the main similarities between the two classes. So there are words that are included in the same class, irrespective of the type of analysis. For example, gentrification, police inequality. Okay, another type of analysis which I wanted to show is the cluster analysis, the hierarchical cluster analysis. In this sense, I employed also the hierarchical cluster analysis. I didn't include it in the PowerPoint presentation, but still is a great way of seeing the data. And in order to better see it, we have to move it a little bit forward. It shows basically the connections between words. You see that there are more clusters, okay, like this. You may see that it has a logic of itself and it perceives basically the main word. So we have the cluster related to violence, contagion, delinquency, then the one related to incarceration and children incarceration and adolescent aggression. Then the one related to murder, incivility and Washington Post, basically the online deviance and political fake news. The one with quality of life and survivors of Sichuan earthquake, which is basically related to internal migrants. A scale related to abstention, a scale affiliation motivation relations, which is basically including the psychological articles from this. Then another group which perceives the articles of stigma, the topics of stigma, gentrification, cohesion, neighborhood police as belonging to the same class, perceiving as such, but still we notice that they are also split into classes. And now I will just try to analyze the main classes as colored ones. Then the class related to substance use and youth and teenagers and family context deviance and some other three classes which may be included in this analysis. I have to mention that in all the analyses I chose to follow the same number of classes, and the 11 seem to be the most consistent, coherent analysis. I employed a lot of classifications in order to obtain these results. Another class which includes the words as education, migrant, border, so it's related to the education of migrants and the issues that they confront when the migrants at the border, okay. Then the well-being class, well-being as linked to discrimination and especially to gender discrimination, and the class related to trauma and polyvictimization and victim. You may notice that this cluster analysis of words still keeps the same data that we had in the topic modeling analysis and also in the co-occurrence network analysis. So going back to the PowerPoint presentation, now I also wanted to show you as illustrative the word frequency queries that I realized based on all the 161 articles analyzed, and especially on what concerns the main topics. I realized this analysis by using word frequency queries in MVivo program, a qualitative software program analysis. And basically, I used the instrument of automated coding. I obtained some main topics, and based on those topics, I I tried to notice the main words, the most frequent words, which relate to a specific topic. So here you have the note, the word cloud of the social dimension. Then here you have the word cloud of online social interaction dimension, the word cloud of behavior dimension, and some more complex metrics word clouds. I don't want to detail this analysis because, as you may see, they have a role of showing the main topics, and still they also show what should I mostly search while related to deviance. So you may see that behavior, delinquency, then social control, this actually shows also domain theories in the domain capital, digital, adolescent, externalizing, delinquent are main words that appear. And they're related to behavior, cyberbullying, victimization, youth, digital, Facebook, adolescent health, delinquent. So you may see that even the word frequency queries add some data to our analysis. I have to mention that this type of analysis, such as word frequency, may constitute only a preliminary step, and they should be followed by some other detailed analysis. Still, today I won't present them, and I will just present some small conclusions as a sketch. So, as I may see from this analysis, online deviance is a relatively new field. It regulates online, regulating the online interactions, like I showed from told you from the beginning, it's still difficult to follow due to the fact that there are a lot of data. We use the word, we employ the word of big data, and they are like coming in the online second by second, so it's hard to keep up with them, with the, all this data. And still, the set of rules is not very clearly defined. We do not have a common understanding of deviance. And we have these two approaches, the positivist and the constructivist one. The limits, the limitations of this study relate to categories consistency, the selections articles, and still data analysis and interpretation may be important limitations. So as a conclusion, I may tell you that this type of instrument allows a data inquiry. Today I showed you an analysis on the topic of deviance, but still one may employ this type of queries also in other topics. And then I also want to show you the main bibliography. This is a selective bibliography. Still, there are some more authors that I need to acknowledge in this bibliography. Thank you very much for your attendance.